Hi everyone, it's Bretta Riches here from runforfoot.com. And today I want to talk to you about why and how barefoot runners are able to run without getting injured as compared to most joggers who run in shoes. Many of us see barefoot runners and wonder why they aren't getting hurt. And there's a specific reason for this. And this reason is known as impact moderating behavior, which seems to be maximized primarily under barefoot conditions and is hampered when a runner wears really thick cushion running shoes. So it's a known fact that we as humans evolved as barefoot runners, and from this, humans have evolved networks of nerves that begin in the feet and travel to the brain. And these nerves, which humans have retained today, which is the main reasons why we have a hard time running in shoes without getting injured, these nerve networks instruct our landing behavior, which includes adjustments in landing intensity to help us avoid high impact landings, hence the term impact moderating behavior for when we run without shoes. So essentially, humans are hardwired to run with less impact when barefoot. And like I said, we didn't evolve to run in shoes, which again may suggest why injury rates are so high in runners. So again, the number one way barefoot runners are able to run with less impact and thus less injury as compared to a runner who runs in shoes is through impact moderating behavior. And this basically means that the body reflexively avoids high impact, painful landings in the absence of soft cushioning under the foot. So the term impact moderating behavior was sort of coined by Dr. Stephen Robbins, and I call him the barefoot professor. He's at McGill University in Montreal. He demonstrated that our natural impact moderating behavior ability works or becomes highly activated through a series of withdrawal reflexes of the leg, which are activated when the cutaneous and pressure-sensitive nerves that line the bottom of the feet are highly activated. These nerves appear to be more activated when we run barefoot and less activated when we run in shoes. So therefore, it would then follow that our impact moderating behavior would be less responsive when we run in very thickly cushioned running shoes. When running barefoot, optimal impact moderating behavior is controlled by the plantar proprioceptors, which are the nerves in the soles of the feet. And these nerves link up and communicate to the nerves in the ankle and knee joints and to the spinal cord and to the motor cortex of the brain. And don't forget that the spinal cord is just as smart and adaptable as the brain. So this means that by adding barefoot running to your training regime, you can fully improve and restore the natural impact moderating behavior and will eventually train your body to land with less impact via landing lighter on your forefoot. So this is a key point I wanted you to remember, is that for our neuromuscular system to stay healthy and active for low impact running, running barefoot is a more well-rounded approach because the spinal cord's ability to coordinate the withdrawal reflexes in the lower leg depends so much on the activation of the sensory nerves in the feet. And as I implied earlier, there is an evolutionary basis for this in that humans evolved as barefoot runners. So it makes sense as to why neuromuscular output really heavily depends on the amount of sensory stimulation on the nerve networks in the feet. When barefoot running, these nerves are highly activated, which provide lots of impact protection. So for example, when we run barefoot on harder surfaces, the nerves in the feet signal the nerves in the spinal cord to instruct the nerves in the knee joint to cause the knee joint itself to slightly bend at touchdown. This increases knee flexion, and knee flexion is a natural way to absorb impact and reduce mechanical work on the knee. So this is how the lower leg sets up for a softer landing when you run barefoot. In my opinion, this is why you want to do a lot of barefoot running training to build muscle memory and to give you better impact moderating behavior. So in other words, the more you run barefoot, the better and stronger and more responsive your lower leg withdrawal reflexes will be. And you end up landing with less impact than you would in cushy shoes. Basically, when we are barefoot, our central nervous system is better able to regulate this impact moderating behavior. So to improve your forefoot running form, you are just better off at increasing your barefoot running training. And I would suggest running barefoot on pavement versus grass, because that's going to give you the best, more clear pressure sensations to help you stay off your heel. So you'll be in a better position to develop a higher snappy back kick. And overall will give you a more perfect forefoot running biomechanical alignment. So that's what I wanted to emphasize today. And so like I said before, up your barefoot running training so that you can run more efficiently in your minimalist shoes and have fun out there on the roads. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And for more information on forefoot running, barefoot running, as well as minimalist running, don't forget to check out my blog, runforfoot.com. And have fun out there on the roads. Bye.